All right, welcome back to This Day in Sports History. And on this day, January the 18th, in the year 1886, modern field hockey as we know it today was born with the formation of the Hockey Association of England. Now, field hockey we've covered back in our Pakistan versus India field hockey video, but we're going to kind of refresh everybody's memory today. It can be played on grass turf as well as an indoor boarded surface. There are 11 players, much like soccer. You have 10 field players and then one goalie. The sticks are made of wood, carbon fiber, and or fiberglass, or some combination of the three. They hit a hard, round plastic hockey ball out on the field, and the stick length will vary depending on your height, but you want it to come up to about your hip. One side is rounded and the other side is flat, and that is the side that you will hit and move the ball with. So if you hit it on the other side, it's actually illegal to do that. The only person that can touch the ball with their body is your goalie. Equipment for field hockey, definitely want to have shin guards just in case, because you are kind of moving low to the ground, and much like when we play hockey at school, anybody who brings that hockey stick up just a little bit, good chance you might get hit in the shins, so shin guards are good. You also see players will wear mouth guards and, of course, uniforms. The International Hockey Federation is what governs field hockey, and they, of course, will govern the Olympics, the World Cup, and the Junior World Cup. See if we can find a few pictures for you, but some form of field hockey has kind of existed for quite some time. There's pictures actually of about 510 BC in ancient Greece, where it looks like they're playing a game similar to field hockey. And they've also seen evidence of field hockey type games back in culture, such as the Egyptian culture, back in ancient China, and also in Northern Europe during the Middle Ages. It is played all across the world. Some of the main countries that play it are countries in Western Europe, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand, the UK, and of course, the United States of America. All right, guys, that is it for today, and we will catch you next time.